For almost 3 years, your favorite global hangout has become a home for timeless stories of global Pinoys. Our ever-growing family has welcomed a number of captains who made our bond stronger than ever. Through every life lesson, overflowing with inspiration. This 2024, as we enter a new era of being always at home with you, we are more than thrilled to welcome the newest addition to our family, Bianca Gonzalez!
I am your host, Bianca Gonzalez of BRGY Season 3.
Only here, where every story is a piece of home.
Be happy!
Be you!
BRGY!
BRGY Season 3.
It's a new day.
Spread the good vibes. Make someone happy today.
The world is opening up. It's time for a ride. Let's rise to the top. Forget, leave your worries behind. Let's talk and have fun. Be together as one. Be who you are. Be who you shine are. Like the stars. We'll be here with you. Let's make the whole world happy.
Hello, BFAM! I am Bianca Gonzalez and I am your host for BRGY Season 3. And as part of my initiation, the TFC team wanted me to take you guys along on my morning or my day leading up into taping our pilot episode. I am super excited. They also gave me 10 questions that I should answer to share with you. And yeah, I'll answer it along the way. So come with me. Let's go. So question number one is if I have any morning ritual. So I don't really have one regular routine because every day is different schedule-wise. But coffee is definitely a part of it. And when I have time, I try to prep doing skincare in the morning, and I'll show you in a bit. So I don't do elaborate skincare like this every day. I do it maybe once a week or once every 2 weeks, but because today is a big day, I will go all out. When I have time, like today, like I mentioned, I do skincare. And one of the things I try to do before a big shoot is the gua sha. There. And yeah, I'll answer a few more questions while I do this. Second question is, what has being a mother taught me? Wow, being a mother has taught me that every child is different and every mother is different. So as much as gusto ko i-compare yung sarili ko sa iba, in the 8 years I have been a mom to an 8-year-old and a 5-year-old, yeah, I have learned that every child is so different and every mom is so different. Okay, next question. Biggest challenge as a mom? Biggest challenge as a mom, I would say, would be the mental load, what they call the invisible load. It's a lot, and it's something I still struggle with, but I try to talk about so that more moms know na hindi kayo nag-iisa sa inyong mental load. Yeah, so that's why doing things for yourself, like what they call self-care now, is really so, 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 so important. So now we're gonna get ready to go for a run, quick cardio for today. We're going for yellow and blue. And yeah, next question is, as a wife, I am blessed to have a husband who is very supportive of me and my dreams. Next question is, it's important for every married couple to maintain respect. I think that in the relationships in general that I have seen that didn't work out, unfortunately, it's when you lose respect for the other person na medyo it goes not as planned. Yung love kasi, it comes and goes, right? Sometimes you're in super, super bliss and then sometimes you really dislike each other. But what I've seen so far, we are 10 years married this year. It's important for married couples to really keep that respect for each other.
Just dropped off my kids at their art class for summer. So usually I drop them off either at school, pero now because it's summer, so I drop them off at swimming, art class, gymnastics, kung ano man yung activity nila. We just went on a coffee run and now we're ready to go to work.
So we are near ABS already and I will answer another question that the TFC team sent me. Sabi nila, what do you think of work-life balance? Parang walang work-life balance. I like to think of it more as a work-life rhythm. Meaning, some days, weeks, months, talagang buhos ka sa work. Kasi wala tayong choice. Kailangan natin mag-work. But some days na mas free, then yun talaga, I make it a point to have time with the family or time with friends, time for myself.
Meron ako napakinggan na podcast recently and they said that it's not actually multitasking kasi the brain cannot do many different things at the same time. Pwede yung kunyari walking and talking kasi walking is very natural to us, etc. But like an active task, instead of multitasking, sabi niya, what we actually do is task switching. So, yun ang feeling ko, isa sa mga strengths ko, that I can task switch very quickly. And I think sobra siyang essential as a mom.
Hello! We're now settled here in the dressing room and I'm about to have lunch. Kain tayo! Yeah, before doing my makeup. Another question that they sent me is, what do you find interesting about stories of Pinoys overseas? Now, just a bit of a background. Actually, over a decade ago, I used to host a show called TFC Connect. Ganun pa, TFC Connect.
Ako po si Bianca Gonzalez at close tayo sa TFC Connect.
Yeah, dun sa mga medyo 40 and above dyan, you might remember it if you had TFC as early as then. And so parang this is a sort of homecoming for me doing BRGY. And another thing is that we are three siblings in the family. Ako lang nandito sa Pilipinas. So my older sister's in London and my older brother is in California. So malapit na malapit sa akin ang kwento ng mga Pinoys overseas. I am so in awe of how they are able to adjust, adapt, and make anywhere their home. To make the Pinoy qualities like warmth, hard work, resilience shine through wherever they are in the world.
Okay, another question that the TFC team asked me to answer. How important is pursuing your other passions despite family duties? I think it's so important for any woman, any person, but especially moms, to pursue things that make them feel whole, that make them feel fulfilled. Kasi super cliche man nung you can't pour from an empty cup, it's so true. Usually, ang mga nanay bigay yan ng bigay. And last, how can our connection to our BFAM overseas widen my perspective as a mom? Shucks, that's such a hard question. Parang pang beauty queen question. But I think that even if I'm not a working mom, like as a person, kapag nakaka-connect ako with our BFAM overseas or global Pinoys or whoever, it just makes you feel you're not alone. Dun sa kung sa ano mang pinagdala mo. Because if there's anything I've learned through this job of interviewing people for 20 years now, even if it doesn't seem it, lahat tayo may pinagdadaanan, lahat tayo merong mga struggles, merong mga journeys. And so when we get to connect, meron tayong shared, I don't know, I guess, something in common. So yeah, I did it! That is the last question on my list. Kaya if you're ready, I'm super ready. Let's go to the studio. Ay! Taray! I love it! Uy, legit na surprise ako. Ha! Thank you! Alam mo, I did TFC Connect when I was starting out as a host, halos. And I remember during that time, ang daming Pinoys abroad who knew me from TFC Connect. Not just PBB or not just at the time why I speak, TFC Connect. So, ang laking parte nun sa akin, and like I said, my family lives abroad. So, yeah, parang magandang homecoming. Wow, meant to be that I'm back. So, thank you!
Just like this, I also can't wait to see how you guys go by your very busy days, lalo na ang global Pinoys natin. Share a day in your life, your struggles, your small and big wins. Be authentic, be generous in sharing a piece of your world with me, with us. I want to see you be you. Join me take over our new and improved studio with our very first guest, who is also mothering in a different side of the world. See her be real when we return, only here on BRGY. Welcome back to BRGY B-Fam. I am your host, Bianca Gonzalez, and we are finally here sa bagong studio ng BRGY! Woohoo! There, listen to everyone! And right here on this set, we will sit down with and listen to our well-loved celebrities and global Pinoys be real and share their inspiring stories. And for our first episode for Season 3, it's my honor to be joined by a global Pinay who really understands the joys and the pains of motherhood. Let's welcome to the show, LJ Moreno! Hello, hello!
Thank you for having me.
Welcome to BRGY, LJ. Let's take a seat on our set and welcome home.
Yes, thank you. So good to be back.
Oh, nakakatuwa. Yes. You relocated height of the pandemic.
Yes, going on, almost 4 years because we actually left September 2020.
Grabe. And speaking of that, at that time, because early last year, you did welcome another addition to the family.
Yes.
Mother of four. Oh my goodness. What is... I have two. Four, I cannot imagine. What's that like?
Well, I definitely have my hands full. As I always, me and Jimmy always joke, I'm like, okay, well, at least I'm still alive because sabi ko, before, here in the Philippines, like, we only had three at the time, mm-hmm. and there was no way that I would go to the mall with the three of the kids with no help at all. So, yeah. Kaya nagdagdag pa ako ng pang-four.
Grabe! Saludo talaga ako. My sister-in-law also, well, two kids now, big na. And I look back and I'm like, how did you do it? How did you do it to any mom who might be watching this with a newborn or biglang two kids?
Yeah.
How?
Well, I always say, it's a lot of prayer, a lot of coffee. and I don't know, I guess you just go with the flow, right?
Oh gosh.
And also, just being used to here, I had my own business. You know, I started working when I was young.
Yeah.
So being like a complete stay-at-home mom, that's a big adjustment also.
Oh,
like,
gosh.
You know, not make, we're used to making our own money, right?
Yeah.
Like, so it's kind of... That's one thing also.
I'm really thankful for my four kids.
Wait, number four was surprise?
Yes. Yes, surprise. I mean...
Meant to be. Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you. No, because it was hard for us to have kids.
Yeah. Okay, yeah. So the four kids are what ages now?
My oldest is 11, 9, 6, and then 1.
Gosh. And everyone has like a different personality, I assume.
Yes, for sure. But everyone just, except for the one-year-old, decided to... play sports.
Yeah.
Some play more than one sport. But then my six-year-old, he really just likes basketball. Mm-hmm. So he plays basketball year-round. But then my girl, she does cheer and she does basketball now.
Okay, yeah.
And then my oldest, his main sport before was taekwondo. Then he shifted. Because in the States, they have different seasons.
Yeah,
so they
correct.
Get to try the different sports.
Grabe. You must be a master time management.
You have to be.
Person.
I was forced to. I was never like really good at time management. But yeah, just to keep my sanity, I really have to.
Ang galing. Wow. Super hands down talaga. Okay. Para mas makilala pa natin si LJ, we have a sort of a game for you.
Okay.
We have here letters of your name. Tama ba ako? Yeah. L okay. and J. Okay, please hold the okay. L and the J. So I'll ask you a few questions and then you will put up the letter of your answer. So L means laban, of course, meaning go or
laban.
Go okay. for it. And J means just wait.
Okay.
Teka lang. Yeah. Okay. Parang ganyan lang. Okay, I will say different scenarios. Okay, this first one is so easy, I totally know what this is. L or laban or just wait. Getting okay. 8 hours of uninterrupted sleep. Just wait.
Ay, sorry. Ano, laban.
Laban. Do you remember the last time you had 8 hours of uninterrupted?
Yeah, I don't even remember. Parang ever since having kids, wala yeah. na. I don't. Before kids, I felt like I couldn't function. Parang ang sungit ko if I don't get 8 hours of sleep. Wow. Pero ngayon, parang okay na kahit 5 hours, 6 hours.
I always say that na parang if you want to give your mothers a gift, it's sleep. Nothing fancy, nothing. Okay din yung fancy, pero patulugin nyo lang ng mahaba. Malaki. Yes. Hopefully, you get to do that here in Manila because
yes.
you're with family and
yes.
help. And
yes.
That's my wish for
that's
you.
It.
Okay.
Thank you.
Laban or just wait? Going out with friends on weekends at this point in
at this point, no. You have to just wait.
Ibibigay ang request ng anak lalo na kapag umiiyak na ito. Laban or just wait?
No. Laban.
Oh,
yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
You're a softie, like pag umiyak na sila.
Yeah. No, I mean, laban. Hindi, mali pala, just wait. Kasi saan laban? Laban, lalabanan ko sila. Yun yung ibig sabihin.
Okay.
Lalabanan
si mommy.
Ko sila. Yun
noted.
Yun.
Yeah. Yeah. So,
kasi ano talaga, I'm the disciplinarian.
Yeah.
Jimmy is the softie. So yeah. pati siya nilalabanan ko talagang with a passion.
Yeah. Okay, this one. Giving your kids screen time during weekdays. Yes,
weekdays,
or just wait?
They just wait because
you're
we
strict
only do,
also.
Yeah, we do screen time only on the weekends. Mm. And my new rule na, kasi nga, in the States, we don't have
yeah.
help. So,
yeah.
noong una, okay, just the weekends. Saka, teka muna, gulo na mga room eh.
Yeah.
So, another ano is, they have to make sure their room is clean before I give them the gadget on a Friday.
Mm.
So, ever since I did that, Thursday pa lang ng gabi, naglilinis sa mga
na.
Room. Kasi gusto nila pag-uwi from school, pwede na mag-gadget. Otherwise, pag-uwi, maglilinis muna sila.
Oh,
so,
smart. Ano. Another hot topic now, isingit ko lang, is have you thought about when you'll allow them social media?
My daughter and my son, they have it, but it's signed onto me. So I
yeah.
let, like, because she likes dancing.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm yeah. like, okay, fine. You can go and look at reels or TikTok only if you're looking for a dance.
Right,
so,
right. Tama naman. So they have to physically get your phone to see
yes,
it.
Yes, and I have to, before they can post anything, I have to screen yeah. the whole thing, or Jimmy has to.
Yeah. Mm, in fairness, good tip. Of course, this spending quality time. With Jimmy, when you can, laban or just wait?
Oh no, laban, syempre.
Yeah, yeah. Do you get to with like his type of schedule?
Yeah, well, we try our best.
I love that. Well, I love talking to moms talaga, especially I get to learn so many things of how they do things. So thanks yeah. for all your tips. I'm sure all our Kapamilya moms were able to get a lot from you, but our kwentuhan does not stop there. Of course, being a mom is so demanding. And kanina pa, we were talking about ni LJ, the different struggles. Of course, we are going to talk about the support system, which you mentioned a bit about earlier.
Yes.
And we will have more mommy stories with LJ when we return here on BRGY. Welcome back to BRGY, BFAM. We are still joined by our super mama of four, LJ Moreno.
Hello again.
Okay, let's rewind a bit because I remember when the news came out about Jimmy getting hired by the NBA. We were all like, what a dream. Like, so what was that like for you? Because you also knew parang what that would entail family time-wise.
I was definitely excited for him. But like, I didn't really... I knew they'd be busy, but I didn't realize how busy until the season started. But the good thing about when he was promoted from G League to NBA, yung sa big team, okay yung support ng team, like for the families.
During off days, during days at his home, is there also teamwork in the house? Is the 11-year-old and the 6-year-old involved in house chores as well? And all
yeah,
that?
They help. My 11-year-old likes to cook. So yeah, then Jimmy, when he's home, he's actually the one in charge of the laundry. So it's funny because when they announced when the news came out here, everyone was congratulating, but he's actually doing laundry. I said, if they only knew what our life was here. So he's in charge of laundry.
Expectation versus reality.
Yes. That was everything else like I do. But he also helps with the kids. Naman. Yeah. That's one thing with Jimmy. Whenever he has time, you know, he makes it an effort na to help out.
I can't believe this. You will be celebrating your 14th anniversary this year. Is it 14?
Yes, 14th. Yeah.
Gosh, so 14 years. I mean, how and what has been, I guess, the key to a successful 14
years? One would be just having God in the center. That's the main thing. Because we always talk about that, because the move to the States could have broken us. Or because there was a lot of challenges, and then, I know, but good thing before we moved, parang yung foundation namin was set na. So that's one thing talaga that helps. Because I always joke about it, but it is true. I'm like, you know what? If I didn't love God so much, I probably would have went home after a year.
Oh, God,
if
so
that,
little.
Yung ganon. Yeah.
Do you have any plans to do any project at all?
Yeah, definitely. I want to because, you know, it's just, I miss it.
Yeah.
You know, it's just, I feel like I'm back to normal when I'm home. So,
oh, yeah. Well, it's part of your system na talaga.
Yes, it is. I mean, we have our family vlog. Yeah. Parang I feel like that's the closest I am to like what we used to, or my past life, parang like sinasabi. Mm-hmm. So, we have that. But yeah, definitely when I'm here, yeah. I always say, yeah, I do want to work. I want to, you know, do guestings and all that stuff.
But I guess you do something similar to what we're doing right now because with Rufo May, is this correct? You produce content, of course, through Mabuhay Studios.
Yes, Mabuhay Studios, so Wonder Mamas. It's just, since Jimmy started at the NBA, it's been hard to schedule. Kasi before, when we started Wonder Mamas, pandemic yun eh. Kasi nga, namimiss namin dito. So.
And for sure that when Pinoys abroad get to watch your lives or your videos, talking and sharing stories, diba, nakaka-relate and feels a little less nakaka-homesick.
Yes, for sure.
Just to wrap up this super sarap na kwentuhan, sarap talaga ng kwentuhan pag mommies. Earlier, we actually asked LJ to prepare some sort of letter to her kids. We've been talking about motherhood ups and downs. And is it okay if we ask you to read to all of us the letter that you have?
Actually, medyo matagal na akong hindi nag-ano sa stationery. So, nakakaaliw, diba? Sabi ko, ba't mo lang amoy? Diba dati yung ano natin during that time? Okay. Alright, this is for the kids. Dear my loves, always remember that I will be here to support you in chasing your dreams. I will always be your number one cheerleader and prayer warrior. Whatever it is that you choose to do, make sure that your number one priority is the Lord so He can guide you every step of the way. And then, my part for Jimmy. Tuloy ko ba? Ituloy ko na.
Pwede naman.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay, go. All right. Baby, thank you for being an awesome father and husband. The last few years haven't been easy, but you never gave up because you knew God had a great plan for us. I want you to know that I appreciate you always being present in our lives and making us feel loved regardless of how busy you are. I am so proud of where you are now, and I cannot wait to see more of God's plans unfold in our lives. I love you.
It's perfect that you wrote a part of the letter to Jimmy because agad-agad, we actually have an answer to your letter.
Oh, so, kaya ba hindi niyo yung number ni Jimmy?
So,
yung may surprise?
This, somewhere, here.
May ganyan?
Oh, wow.
LJ is an amazing mother to all four of our kids. But I think the one thing that stands out to me the most is just the time, the energy, and the love that she showers our kids with on a daily basis, whether it's running them to school early in the morning or taking them to a dance or a baseball or a basketball practice, her energy never wavers. She's constantly pouring all of her energy and her love into our children to give them the best life possible. So we love you, and I'll see you soon.
Aww.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Jimmy.
Grabe, nagulat naman ako doon.
Surprise!
Akala ko tulog siya eh. No? Hinihinima yung number. May surprise to.
Oh, the letter that we asked LJ to write is just to her kids. Pero on her own, you really wanted to pour that out for Jimmy too. And obviously, he adores you as much.
Thank you.
I felt like that felt like a big hug to every couple living abroad. Na ganun din yung dynamic. I mean, so I hope na na-comfort din kayo ng letter ni LJ and then words ni Jimmy. Maraming salamat.
Thank you. Thank you.
I know that you are still super jet lagging as in kahapon lang siya dumating.
Yes.
So thank you for taking time to share your story here
of
on our first episode.
Yes, thank
of
you
season
for having
three.
Me. Yes. Congratulations on season 3.
Thank you. No, thank you for being a part of it. And if you would like to invite everyone to follow your YouTube channel and anything you want to promote, please share it.
Okay. Yes, please follow our family vlog, Alapag Family Fun. We also have a Facebook page, Alapag Family Fun. My Facebook page, LJ Moreno Alapag. And of course, Babuhay Studios on YouTube and Facebook as well. So we do live streams every week.
Maraming salamat again for making time for us.
Yeah.
Let's
thank
give a big
you.
Round of applause to LJ Moreno! Woohoo! Gosh, and of course, as you know, napakalaking bagay para sa ating mga kababayan everywhere. And you know what, to this day, I've been working on TV and you as well, you've been working in media for a long time. Pero parang pag binabati tayo, nakakilig. Ako, whenever nakarinig ako ng bati, parang kinikilig pa rin ako.
Oo, ano,
super! So, yeah. We would like to give a shout-out sa ating mga kababayan wherever you are in the world here on BRGY Shoutout. Hello to Michaela Buenafe from Abu Dhabi. Hello to John Arman Garcia from Australia. To Christine Gabrielle Concepcion from Canada. Hello sa inyong lahat! Do you wanna say hi to any family member or friend abroad?
Yes, of course.
In the world?
Well, yeah. Of course, my kids. Ian, who was left with Jimmy. Hi, Kuya. And of course, my kids. Kaylin, other kids. Kaylin, Kiona, and Kaysen. And all our friends also that are watching from Roseville, California.
Yeah.
And all our kababayans around the world. All the OFW families or military families.
Yeah.
You know, hi, and we appreciate all the hard work.
Yes, definitely. So if like LJ, you also want to shout out your own BFAM anywhere in the world yan, mag-comment lang sa ating pinned post sa TFC Facebook page and baka sila na ang susunod na mabati dito sa BRGY. And there you have it, BFAM. Thank you so much for joining us in jump-starting our newest season. And asahan nyo na mas makakilala pa tayo ng marami pang Pinoy celebrities, trailblazers, global Pinoys who will join us for BRGY Season 3. Samahan nyo rin akong kilalanin ng mas lumalaki pang pamilya ng ating bikada from all over the world. Now, before we say goodbye, allow us to thank our generous friends who made BRGY Season 3 possible. Thank you to IKEA for our very homey, diba,
oh, yes.
Set. For season 3, maraming maraming salamat. And if you loved our super homey setup here in the studio, you can get more inspiration for your home dito sa Pinas with IKEA.ph. Of course, you have quality, affordable, and sustainable IKEA home furnishings online. And you can have it delivered straight to your home or families dito sa Pilipinas through the IKEA Philippines online store. That's IKEA.ph. And of course, kung nabitin kayo sa ating kwentuhan for today, you can always rewatch our episodes. Just go to ABS-CBN Entertainment Channel on YouTube and search for BRGY. Of course, pwede nyo rin kaming mahanap sa I Want TFC app. That's anytime, anywhere. All you have to do is download the I Want TFC app. In case wala pa ha, you can download it on Google Play and the App Store. Or you can also visit iwanttfc.com and watch all your favorite Kapamilya shows. Also, you can subscribe to our TFC Facebook account for more exciting and exclusive BRGY content. And of course, to stay updated for all the events brought to you by the Filipino channel. Muli, maraming salamat, LJ Moreno.
Thank you so much.
This has been Bianca Gonzalez giving you a home away from home only here on BRGY. Bye! See you tomorrow!